if 100 people have tasted alcohol, 15% would become addicts. Out of those who have tasted brown sugar, 23% become addicts. And out of those who have tasted tobacco, 32% become addicts. It's the most addictive substance known to mankind. All of you may have seen occasional drinkers. Party to party drink karte hain, beech mein drink nahi karte. How many of you have seen occasional smokers? Most of them need their smoke every day within half an hour of getting up. 70% smokers want to quit, but only 2-3% succeed. That is how addictive tobacco is. It is not less addictive, it is more addictive. Next. So, look at these packets. What do they look like? Poisons? Or some sort of refreshment? Chocolates? They definitely don't look like poisons. This is how the tobacco companies are marketing this poison to the children of our country. And more than 50% of children in the poor socioeconomic strata are addicted to it. They are fooling the children of our country and we are allowing them to. Okay? A tobacco packet has a warning. A gutka packet has a warning, not for minors. A cigarette packet has a warning, not for minors. 50% people in your society take it. Who is responsible? Those minors, the companies, the government, or we, educated citizens, who are looking at this drama of exploitation and remaining silent. Right? Next. Is it normal? Many people when we say that, bola yaar, sala smoke nahi karega to friendship karega kisse? Sabhi to smoke karte. But just because it is common in your group, doesn't make it normal. More than 50% people in the world do not touch alcohol or tobacco. Okay? Most successful scientists, sportsmen, etc. do not use it. Exceptions are there. There are exceptions of smokers who would be very successful and there are exceptional non-smokers who would not be successful. But talk of the rule. Majority addicts, subah hote hi paan thalle pe baithenge, bade bade gappe fekam phak karenge aur their life ends there. That is their achievement in life. Nothing beyond that. Okay? Fine. Tambakucha shetala kumpan lagat nahi. A tobacco farm doesn't need fencing. Why? Kyunki ghadon ko aur dukron ko bhi samajhta hai ki tambaku khana nahi chahiye. Wo log khate nahi hai. Insaan khate hai. Okay? Next. Okay? Peer pressure. I repeat, I'm predominantly making the lecture to empower you to counsel the children in your family, to your friends, do not start. Okay? When you're saying this to a child, do not start. You have to empower him to deal with the peer pressure. Okay? Let me just, yeah. You have to empower him to deal with the peer pressure. Fine. Because peer pressure, that 60% start because of peer pressure. So you have to empower him, right? Supposing someone comes and he says, nahi, mummy maregi, nahi. So fir gaya. They're going to make sure that he will start it. They're going to put after him. But he looks them bold into the eye and says, gutka? Aisi faltu cheeze main nahi karta. Don't ask me again. When he says in a clear tone, no one is going to bother him again. They know ke daal yahan galne wali nahi hai. Right? If they argue, so arguments are in your side. If they say, mard nahi kya tu? Say, mard hoon, mard rehna chahta hoon, aur isi liye cigarette nahi le raha. Tere ko bhi agar mard rehna ho, to tu bhi band kar de. Arguments on your side, why are you afraid? Right? And so, joining a good spiritual group or a good NGO or a good cultural group is one of the best insurances for your family. Because that will make sure that you will have a healthy peer group who would guide your taste in a healthy direction. Next. Fine. A few easy tips to quit. I'll really go fast through this. Okay. I'll just highlight 3 or 4 main ones. The second one, no, it's a battle in the mind. One mind says, "Arey, chhod de, bahut kharaab hai, iske wajah se itna nuksan ho raha hai, vagere, vagere, vagere." The other mind, as soon as the craving comes, "Kal se chhod denge yaar, chal abhi le le, ek mein kuch farak nahi padta." It's a constant battle. And you have to increase the power of this side of the mind. How do you do it? Read the list of adverse consequences twice a day. Every day. As soon as you get up, before your bed, minimum. Remaining, it's up to you. That builds up your motivation to quit. Second thing, ye jo list hai, usme bhi, what appeals to you the most? Out of all the things I told, you know, for different people, different things might be important. Make a priority list, the 3 or 4 main things why you want to quit. And keep that shit in your pocket. Because when craving comes, your mind doesn't function. It gets burned. At that time, you cannot think. At that time, either someone has to tell it to you, or take out that shit and read. When you read, suddenly light will come to your mind. Happiness nahi hai, dukh hai. Not to take it. Reading the list at that time or phoning your friend and asking him to remind you all the damage which alcohol or tobacco has done to him till now, the craving will get crushed then. Okay, that is one thing you can do. Second thing, as I told, tobacco is more addictive than alcohol. It doesn't, generally when people try and, many people go cold turkey in one day, but it is advisable to tell him, taper the tobacco over seven days. So that the withdrawal symptoms would not be so strong. Taper it over 7 days and after 7 days, quit. It may help you in decreasing the withdrawal, which make it almost impossible to quit. Okay, next. Next. Just as peer pressure makes you start to smoke, peer pressure can help you quit too. Convince your friends who are smoking and together start to quit. The probability you will succeed is more. Craving is like a wave. You suddenly see a person smoking and you feel smoke. But just like a wave, it comes suddenly. Like a wave, it goes off also suddenly. All you have to do is control for those 10 to 15 minutes. Either by talking to a friend or by sleeping or by eating something good or by seeing a good film or by whatever. Whatever you like. Distract your mind for 10 to 15 minutes and the wave would be gone. Okay? Next. Next. Daily talk with at least one person about the harmful consequences of tobacco. I'm not asking you to be a hypocrite. You're not saying, main nahi leta, tu bhi mat le. No, main leta hun. I mean, if you're taking, okay? Main leta hun aur chhut nahi raha. Ya, main leta hun aur maine aaj tak itna itna nuksan sahaya hai. I don't want you to face it. So please, you don't start or you quit. You know, listening is comfortable. You can take a nap in between. You can do this, you can do that. And it's very convenient. But to convince someone, your mind has to process a lot of it. Okay? And in the whole process, your mind would get convinced that it is bad. And there is a sort of peer pressure which you are building up. Every day when I am talking to someone, bahut bura re, chhod de, bahut bura re, chhod de. People are looking at me. That also sort of builds up a pressure on me to quit, which is good, na? Okay? So daily talking to at least one person and motivating him to quit is a good idea. Next. Fine, so that was at the next. That was at the individual level. Next. Even at the group level, fine. I'm predominantly working at the group level. I'm not working at the individual level. I'll tell you why in the coming slides. Okay? First one of it is, not only individuals, the society as a whole is getting harmed. Just because you don't smoke, doesn't mean you are not getting harmed. Okay? First, main reason, the most probable, the common reason why people start is peer pressure. So, if it is common in the society around you, be prepared. You may hear the news very soon that your son, your brother, your friend has started to smoke. If you think it can happen everywhere but not to you and your family, then you are trying your luck a bit too hard. Okay. So I'll just rush through it. It decreases the efficiency of the human resource of our society by causing premature deaths, by decreasing the work performance, by increasing the job absenteeism, etc. By decreasing the academic performance, as we saw, it keeps the work strata educationally backward because they drop out from school earlier. Next. Third, it maintains the poverty in our country. Let's analyze the study in Gadchiroli. In Gadchiroli, what they found was 81% of the adults consume tobacco, 50% of the adult female, I mean adult males, 81%, 50% of the adult females consume tobacco. How much? Every day they spend, a male every month spends 160 rupees on tobacco. I mean, a one who is taking tobacco, and a tobacco taking female spends 77 rupees on tobacco. All of you must have heard the concept of bachat ghat.